has been some big movement here and big money late here coming for Northern Decree. It's the second most popular, but we've written three bets here late from three separate TAB customers, one at $3,500, one at $2,200 and another at $1,000 on Northern Decree, which is written at $4. So it's $4.20, or in fact as much as $4.40 into $3.90 now at $4. And Make It Flashy does jump up the order here. It's the third most popular runner, but firming in a big way, $4.40 into $3.70. Care of another big bet too for $2,500 on Make It Flashy. So they're the top three. Not a heap of money coming for Viminelli, I must say, despite the firm. It's $6.50 into $4.80, but not a heap of money moving it. And then pick of the roughies is Saweetie, as you probably might expect, at double figures as an $11 chance. All right, we are going to head back to Paul and Kian.
Thanks for that, Don. Now, Golden Boom, carrying the same weight as Thelwell. You know how big Golden Boom is.
Yes.
And now you've seen this guy in the flesh. How tough is he?
Thelwell, he's very tough. Yeah, he's a tough little racehorse. And look, he's out to 3:30 if you want to jump on him today with the claim. I think he gets his chance, but, you know, he'll need to stand up and win this race today. It's been a long time between drinks, and he may just deserve this one today. But there's good opposition. Northern Decree, Make It Flashy, really meeting with some late support, as is Viminelli. So an interesting race coming up. Let's head upstairs to Josh. This is race six at Eagle Farm.
As we spoke about before, Warwick Racing tomorrow. Heavy eight at the moment, but the rain pulled up last night. Had a little light shower very, very late, but all that the bulk of that rain's gone. So heavy eight and clearing conditions for tomorrow. So they're all in here at Eagle Farm. Red light turned on, and we're right to run. Gates open, they're racing, and Bean Groovy began sweetly. Likewise, Viminelli, Thelwell is right up there, Handy as noted. Saweetie's out three and four wide, Cherokee Girls even wider, followed further back by Northern Decree, who's gone back to second last. Last of all is Make It Flashy. So Thelwell's in front, second Bean Groovy, third noted. There's one out three wide, Saweetie going four, Viminelli between them. Further back to Northern Decree, Cherokee Girl went back to the second last over on the outside, one away from the fence now, and Make It Flashy's at the rear, five lengths off the leader. Thelwell, 600 metres left to run, just in front from Bean Groovy. Saweetie's been wide, noted Viminelli, Northern Decree is third last on the inside of Cherokee Girl, and Make It Flashy's at the rear. 400 metres left to run, Thelwell's in front, felt for second, Bean Groovy, noted the inside, running home, weaving through Northern Decree. Saweetie's been wide and further back to making ground now, Make It Flashy. Thelwell's in front, but coming home strongly. It's Northern Decree, the inside. Make It Flashy's running home up to third, but Northern Decree shot through, quickly took over for Martin Harley. Coming away, it's in front from Make It Flashy late. Northern Decree in front, and Northern Decree's one from Make It Flashy, Viminelli. Photo for Thelwell Saweetie, followed by Bean Groovy, Cherokee Girl, and No to drop right out to pull up at the rear.
Five, six, ten, and a photo. Northern Decree, Martin Harley riding for Robert Heathcote. Saved ground coming into the straight. The runs came. The revs were building up. The favourite got the white flag at about the 200-metre mark, Thelwell, and Northern Decree said, I'll take that. See you later. He's gone right on with the job. Make It Flashy settled last as run second, so a slashing return there from the six. And Viminelli, just have to watch the replay. I wasn't watching him closely. He was fifth one off the fence coming to the turn, and he was going to have to take a gap if he was going to win, but my eyes weren't on him. They were on Northern Decree, driving through hard along the inside. As we patch the replay here, you can see Make It Flashy coming across hills. Thelwell really got a stitch. CJ Graham had given him every possible on speed, so it may be a long time till he wins one, but not for Northern Decree. He's onwards and upwards, 5, 6, 10 and 12. Saweetie has grabbed that fourth spot. 5, 6, 10 and 12, your numbers in race 6, paying around about the $4 mark across all totes and jumped officially at $4 on the SP. So a nice result there if you're stuck solid with number 5, Northern Decree. All right, Kian was making her way out towards the enclosure, and Robert Heathcote's here, Leah Kilner's here. So, Kian, I'm not sure who you're going to grab out of those two, but the floor is yours.
I've just plucked Leah out of the ruck. Gee, I love this horse. Do you love this horse too?
Oh, we do. Look, he's a horse with a very bright future, and we chose to come to this race just to give him a nice confidence boost, and he's one like that, so he's got bright things ahead.
And that's a good, confident, boosting run too. He got a beautiful smother. He was able to come up the fence. Just like his trial, I like how sort of Martin kept him out of the ruck a little bit. And he's a lovely sized horse too. Plenty to like about him.
Oh, look, there is. There's plenty to like about him. He come from New Zealand. His owners picked him out. And look, he's a lovely animal just to look at, and we've always liked him from the start. And then, yeah, like you said, Marty gave him a beautiful ride. He got smothered up, he waited for the gaps, and he electrocuted, and he was perfect to the line.
Was. Thank you so much, Leah. Great job.
Hey, thank you.
All right, Leah Kilner there representing Team Heathcote, and Northern Decree gets win number 2. Start number 8, building a nice record and a very nice horse moving forward. 5, 6, 10 and 12, that's the 6th event here at Eagle Farm. Well, Martin, that couldn't have worked out any more perfect for this horse's return. He's a lovely horse.
He is a lovely horse. I sat him the other morning and really, really liked him. He's a beautiful character and good personality, beautiful action, good wind, and you haven't seen the finished product yet. When he gets over a bit more ground, he's going to be really interesting.
Yeah, he's a bit of a box ticker, isn't he? Size, scope, he's put together well, he's got a good set of lungs. That barrier trial, I think you rode him in, you sort of just kept him out of trouble, kept him wide, nice quiet trial.
I didn't ride him in the trial.
It wasn't you? Well, they did a good job of it.
Yeah, he did. Listen, he tried out good. But see, I just had to sit on him and track work the other morning, and yeah, I was very pleased with him.
Well done.
Thank you.